funny like this. It's how you step. Hello, Falava.
Malolele. Bula Binaka Fresh.
Welcome to the South.
The real South is in the South Island. I'm Wasaki Naholo.
Malakai Fikito.
I'm Nasimane. And it's our pleasure to bring you fresh from Four South Bar Stadium.
In the beautiful Dunedin.
Home of the Highlanders.
Coming up fresh for today. Uncle Sam's takes
confessions.
I'm a proud Samoan. Yeah, I love my mum.
We check out a slice of the world of this man.
Put it down to the power running of Malakai Fekitoa.
And check out moves better than Wasaki's and hit the floor. First up,
everyone's favourite celebrity stalker.
Bajali. Oh, Bunny. Is that how you say it?
Bunny Ratsy.
It's me, Barney, here at the beautiful Auckland Zoo. As you all know, I don't find it very hard to find a man, So it only made sense that I came to the Auckland Zoo to be surrounded by more beasts, you know. And the exciting thing was, perfect timing, because Sole and Mew are here as well. They're performing here. And I figured I should be here too, because I want to approach Sole and Mew and tell them that they should rebrand, sort of like change their name, change the concept. You know how they're Sole and Mew? What about Sole and Sunga Meow? You see what I did there? I went meow. You got it? Okay, cool. Can I get a high five, Sipulu? Doe deer, female deer, brave, tropical golden sun. Guys, I have this really amazing idea. Oh, I was thinking of Sole and Sunga Meow. Because we're at the zoo. Sole Sunga Meow. Oh. What do you reckon?
You know, we need to hear the raw talent first, so give us what you've got.
Okay. You make me feel like a natural woman. But if it's opera, it's gotta have to be like, natural woman. What do you reckon?
Whoa. That was
definitely raw.
Yeah, I've got some tips. Repeat after us.
Yeah, okay.
Ma.
That's actually really. Sorry. I'm so sorry. That's really sore.
Sorry.
Ma. Guys, they're saying that when girls listen to you guys sing, you make them go into this really bizarre space. And so I was wondering if it's just a rumor, to confirm whether that rumor is a fact or fiction. That was amazing. Thank you guys so much. Thank you guys so much. That was amazing. To ask me, because I feel like I've asked you like a gazillion questions now.
How do you keep lusciously beautiful and single?
I don't have to be single if you want to do something about it.
Oh! Have it, guys. I had the most amazing time with the boys. They obviously didn't buy the Sole and Sunga Meow concept, but that's okay. One thing's definitely a given. When these boys sing, your muckas really do go like this, and they really do make you want to roar. And you're gonna hear me
roar. Stay tuned for more super freshness after the break.
Please come back. It was always part of my plan to make the ABs, but it happened that quick. So now I'm making another plan and focus to the World Cup.
Arthritis.
Yes, sir, roger that. Missile launch in 5, 4, 3.
Oh, what's this?
A missile launch?
I didn't arthritis. Who's arthritis? Who write this? Did arthritis?
Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man. Yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man.
Manolele, welcome back to Fresh. My name is Malachi Fikitoa, and he's a slice of my world.
There's 14 of us in our family, 6 brothers and 7 sisters. My first day at primary school when I was 5, I was chasing my little cousin one time and then I pulled one of the door, so the door fell and caught me on my hip. The next day, woke up, just couldn't do anything, couldn't walk. After that incident like happened, like people like call me names in Tongan, translated to English, it's cripple. They call me polio, poly. Yeah, that's what happened. Up the strong island nation. Now that's when I wanted to move over and try to prove everyone wrong from my island, and that made me, you know, train harder to get to where I am now. It was really hard. It was one of the hardest decisions I've made, you know, leave all my families behind and coming in to chase my dreams. I remember in winter, my first year at school, everyone were wearing jumpers and, like, you know, long pants and stuff like that, but I was wearing, like, rugby shorts and a T-shirt because I couldn't have anything. I remember I got mocked all the time that I just wanted to show off my muscles, but really I didn't have anything else. You know, I was so fresh back then and I couldn't understand people and I couldn't talk, and, you know, that's the hardest thing ever because I couldn't communicate with coaches, to players next to me. But lucky enough, there was more Tongan at Wesley College to help me out.
Advantage is over. Here's Fikitoa. Fikitoa now, one to beat.
Yeah, after school I made the Auckland Academy, and then they told us that if you're not going to communicate properly and you're not going to understand anything, then you're not going to become professional, you know. And that's what happened. I worked hard on it. They sent me to some English class, and, you know, I've always tried to talk and always tried to learn. I got used to Auckland and I loved it there, and I called it home, but then I had 2 more years left, but they cut me and I was like, oh, I thought, you know, that's it for me. It was hard, but you gotta get knocked up, you know, so bad first before you get back up again and go up to, you know, even better, and then that's what I did, and lucky enough to get the chance to come into the Highlanders.
Fikitoa. Wow, so strong and brilliant run from Fikitoa. This is sheer brilliance.
I think everyone in New Zealand
knows the answer to why we like Malachi. He's been in sensational form.
It was always part of my plan to make the ABs, but it happened that quick, so now I'm making another plan and focus to, you know, to the World Cup. Part of it is for my family, you know, for them to be proud of. I see in their eyes when I go home how different they are now when compared to when I used to go back. You know, I just wanted to make them proud and be happy for at least a little while. I know that it's not anyone can play for this country, and it's the best team in the world, and I'm lucky enough to be in it, and that's how special that is.
Okay, check yourself, because coming up next, some fresh facts.
And welcome to Fresh Facts, your favorite part of the show to make your brain exploding with heaps of information to make you go to the university. This week our subject is rugby. Yes, rugby is a very important one to me because I was almost playing for the All Black. Yes, I know it's amazing to believe it, but I was ungrateful. Anyway, rugby was first come to the island in approximately 1800, 1900, and that first island was Fiji. Ooh. Yeah, it was teached to them by the British soldier in those days. Oh. In some of the other islands, the rugby was brought to them by the Mary's brothers missionary. Oh. It's a little bit stupid because they're teaching us to play rugby and then they can't play on Sunday. And in 1938, the Maori All Black decided to tour the island and play their brown cousin up in the Pacific.
Stripper.
And when Samoa was play Fiji a few times, I hear there's a big tree in the middle of the field. Aye. And you have to run around it. And that's why I think the Islander is the one who invented the sidestep. Another amazing fact, in 1972, the Tongan rugby team was play OC. That's right, the mighty Australian Wallaby. Ooh. And guess what? Yeah, the Wallaby lose. Aye. And that Tongan team is a hero because a lot of the OC got carried off on a stretcher to the ambulance. Probably saying,
"Man, they can come, did you see the size of those thighs?"
Oh. And last of all, we have contributed so many Islanders to make the All Black. It's gone back to Brian Williams and Michael Jones and all these great people. True. And on, so many names, I can't name it. But if you're looking at all those teams now, OC, England, even America, Canada, and Wales, they all have an Islander. Even France has an Islander. Bonjour, Uso. Because it all began with that great Second World Cup with Achona Lomu. And he was running over England, especially running over Mike Getz, who later on changed his name to Mike Flats. God. That's enough from me, Matua Pototele. I tune in next week with more Prenny Advisors.
Amigos.
Wise, I heard you could dance.
No, you
think you're a bit of a dancer?
Am I?
Yeah, I've seen it before. Show us. Oh, no. That's enough.
Yeah.
Sad, man.
Here's some guys who can actually dance. Hit the floor.
$5 and you got 6 fish, 10 hot dogs, 4 ice block, 3 loaves of bread, and 2 diet soda.
Hey, who's your favorite NRL player?
Daniel Carter.
Yeah.
Anna.
Conda.
Anaconda.
Hey, I told you don't play off mummy's lipstick again, eh?
Shut up.
Excuse me? Go and set Anaconda. Mate. Hurry up.
Anaconda, don't.
Huh?
Welcome back to Fresh. We're coming back at you from the deep south this morning.
Highlanders represent.
Yeah, yeah.
Represent. Yeah, yeah. Time to check out Uncle Sam and this week's confessions.
Confessions.
Yeah.
Gone.
Yeah, gone. Yeah, Minaka. Malo.
Minaka.
Hi, I'm Oscar. I'm just about to go into the confession booth and see Minister Sam and unburden about a secret that I've been struggling with, that I think I'm the only islander to suffer from. Hopefully he can help.
Welcome, my son. What would you like to confess today?
I'm a proud Samoan. Yeah, I love my mum. And you know how everyone says, oh, my mum, you know, her chop suey is the best. Oh, her pineapple pie is the, you know, really great. Oh, fali fo fai. I hate my mum's cooking.
Is that right? I don't know any Samoan who eats a mum's cooking and it doesn't taste good. I notice you're not as big as most Samoan, you know?
That's why.
That's why. So, when you eat your mum's fali fo fai, what does it taste like?
It's like eating vegetables.
Oh, even you saying vegetables make me want to... What type of vegetable?
Like one of those balangi ones that they put in everything, and they go, oh, we got no meat, but here's an eggplant.
Oh, is that right?
Aubergine.
Oh, not an aubergine. Not an aubergine. And most of the cooking is done, obviously, with the home oven?
Yes.
Is it electrical or is it gas?
Electrical.
Oh, is that right? I think I might have some strategies. You know where the fuse box is? And what you can do is you take the fuse of the oven, is because when you take it, you refuse that appliance in your house. Yeah. And if you put it in the wrong place, then you confuse.
And I diffuse the stress in our relationship.
Yes.
What if she says, oh, son, can you buy me an oven?
Well, if it's still an electrical oven, you don't have to put the fuse in and say, oh, something's wrong. You know, we have to rewire. Your mom would rather get free takeaway, cheap takeaway food, than rewire the whole house.
You can spend like $15 if you get a free sausages.
Yeah,
a fish.
Yeah. Well, you go to South Auckland, $5, and you got 6 fish, 10 hot dogs, 4 ice block, 3 loaves of bread, and 2 diet soda. And wow, that feeds at least 2 people. You see, how incredible is that?
You're a wise man.
Well, I mean, I know we're all the parking side when it comes to fast food. Hey, look at me. You know, I'm good build of health. Oh, yeah.
Good build of health.
Yeah, good build of health, man.
I feel amazing after. It was good to unburden some secrets that have been poisoning me. So, yeah, feeling good.
I am so sorry for Oscar. I'm so sorry for him. He had to go through this while he's growing up. And an island mom who cooks food that tastes like vegetable? I never heard of this thing. I never experienced this thing. This is torture. This is inhumane. It's not right. You can't put people through this thing. That's what the cows eat the crust, not the human.
What's fresh mean to you, Doc?
I don't know, dogs. Maybe if you can talk like me. Nah, it means a lot of things, I suppose.
Not really. Here on Fresh, there's fresh and there's fresh.
Are you sure that doesn't even make sense?
Fresh moves.
Maybe you guys should try the fresh test.
Hey, we're fresh.
We're super fresh.
Fresh is good. Fresh is the best.
Fresh of the best. Fresh are the best. Whatever.
How fresh are you? Uh,
who is your favorite body player in the whole NRL?
Body player.
Polynesian, or Melanesian, or Micronesian. Yeah. Who's your favorite NRL player of all time? Give me your favorite NRL player.
Probably gonna have to say GI, but pretty much anyone who plays in the green and red.
Is that Glenn Innes or?
Yeah, GI, Glenn Innes.
Glenn Innes. Who's your favorite player?
Sam Burgess.
Sam Burgess.
Billy Slater on top.
Yes, Slater. Jonathan Presty.
Daniel Matuidia. Matu Vatavai.
Hey man, I'm trying to find this team. They call him the South Sydney Rabbit Horse. Hey, who's your favorite NRL player?
Daniel Carter.
Yeah.
I like all the Warriors. I can't pick one, brother. I love them all.
How fresh are you, mate?
Very fresh.
Who's your favourite NRL player other than yourself?
Brent Tate.
He's all right.
He's all right, yeah.
So I was his favourite?
Yeah.
Of course I am.
Of course you are.
Well, that's us fishies. It's been a pleasure being with you guys today.
Take care of yourselves and each other.
Make sure you come back next week for some more freshness for your Saturday morning.
Sayonara.
Sarai con me, tu non sarai più sola. Quanto ti voglio bene, queste parole.